again, a good part of this stuff has been done by the professor, so I'll skip most of that. But I just refer to the Mawingu deployment of TVWS space. For regulatory reasons, I'm still going to call it a pilot, because what really happened was that the competition authority gave us authorization to pilot TVWS space sometimes in 2013. And we did run that pilot for close to 2 years. So we piloted it, we used it. In fact, the current distributed Mawingu network, which is running on other technologies, was basically backbone by the TVWS space. So we were using the same mass, same base stations, just changing the equipment. So I'm going to refer to telepilot. So something interesting is that the first Africa implementation of TVWS space demonstration was actually done here in Kenya, Microsoft and Adaptra at the UN complex in Gigiri. CA gave them authority to do that, and they actually showed that. And some of the founders of Mawingu were actually also involved in that demonstration. So on August 2013, we were given that authorization to pilot TVWS space in this country. There were several objectives. This was one, a push by Microsoft, two, a push by Mawingu, and then three, an attempt by CA to see whether TVWS space can actually be deployed commercially without any of the issues that people are thinking will happen, interferences and such. So we used a point to multipoint technology, just like our friends in Malawi are doing. That's after a demonstration of the network in which we try to test it. It's actually a wide span of land over the Kibia County. So we decided that we are going to use solar power. Most of these areas really had no grid. And even when there was grid, we opted that solar power was going to be, in the long run, more efficient. At the core of the rollout, we had so many spots that we actually put on the network. Those are some of the samples. We had some library with 10 users, some schools with 315 students, the Red Cross Office 7 staff, farm 35 employees, some secondary schools. There were myriad schools, farms, other social service areas, the government. We wanted to actually show the CA that it will work irrespective of what the user's requirement will be. What is important is actually what we came out with. And I'm going to outline some set of technical results that was very important for us as Mawingu, because this is a technology that we were to use going forward. And all the CA also wanted, and of course for the benefit of Microsoft. So for that time, between 2013, August, and by the time we ended the pilot, about 2 years later, we were able to show that we can actually drive this thing over 14 kilometers on a point to multi-point range. And if we had to limit our power at the base station, 2.5 watts. So 14 kilometers, 2.5 watts of power. We were able to show that with that kind of setup, we can actually cover about 240 square kilometers of land. We were using 90 degrees sectoral antennas for that. We were also able to show, using the equipment we had at that time, that we could get a maximum per session use of 16 megabits per second on 1.8 megahertz TV channel up to a distance of 14 kilometers. No interference was shown by any of the concerned parties. There was no interference with the equipment or network during the test period. We had a target of 99.8% availability. We was assured that any type of protocol could be utilized by TVWS, because that was also something that was important for those who are looking at that. So we could stream, we could do email, we could do anything. Anything that actually works. Yeah, works on TVWS, like it works on any other. We used solar, so we also proved that we can actually drive TVWS without the need of grid. There was no interference to the TV stations, because that was also important. No TV service was interfered with. There was no detectable increase in the noise flow on the UHF band. That was very important for CAK. We also showed that we could achieve co-channel operation at low power levels. We saw that solar power can actually drive a TVWS base station throughout. It can drive also the backhaul radios. We also proved that we can use cloud-based services to actually manage the network components of a TVWS base distributed network. We found out that operating below 4 watts was actually the best with the equipment that we had to give us maximum spectrum reuse. The Kenyan people who were well versed with the installation of other wireless technologies will as well actually deploy it in the white space. That was also important. And then we know that that time the 802.11 AF was really the standard that was interesting us. And we are aware that chip manufacturers are coming up with this. So future generation laptops will most likely be having 802.11F chips along. So that will even make TVWS space not only their distribution technology, but up to the access level. We could use standard prediction tools, because that's something that you want to test as an RF planner. Most of the RF engineers will probably use your mobile tool and other free or shared applications. Which we actually are able to prove that we can use the mobile pretty accurately, and we'll get to almost 80-90% tenant coverage without buying expensive PABs and the rest of those other software. We will get to low frequency densities. And the hardware that we were testing that time, which we are also still using now, we actually proved that they were reliable and we had no failure over the entire 18 or so months that we lived there. What we also learned was that it's not one band fit all. Whereas TVWS space is very good, we use that. We at Mawingu took the approach of using TVWS space in addition to 5 gig and any other gigs that we will get for backhaul or for access, and thereafter. So it's a combination band network. What equipment do we use? We tried two types of equipment. The adapter and the 6 harmonics. So by the way, we set together the adapter with the CESR1, and then thereafter, by the time we're finishing, we use the ACSR2. It's very interesting, if you come to our lab, you'll see an $18,000 adapter box that we used for the base station when we started. By the time we finished the test, that had dropped down to just slightly below 1,000. I think it's now much smaller than it was when it started. So that's the second generation of the adapter, ACR2. 6 harmonics was another equipment vendor that we also piloted. So we had equal both. So we had half 6 harmonics and half adapters. That's how 6 harmonics look like. So that's our typical setup. Normal antenna on a kiosk, solar power, and then you have an indoor CPE that will receive or batch baseband. it was important for the CA to know that we can monitor TV workspace transmissions. So we had to prove to them that both the dark cam and the six harmonics could give us monitoring capabilities. So we would log in via some interface that we can see what's going on those channels. Our efficiencies, as per the last radio, we rolled out basically 1.2 megabits per megahertz on the forward and 1.5 megabits per megahertz on the channel. That's based on 64 QAM. Of course, this is now improving as time goes. The throughput is a function of several issues. One is path loss, the physical capabilities of the radios, so the modulation scheme, the path, and the LLA performances, and then the efficiencies of the other layers that we have in the deployment. And then, of course, the transport protocol that one uses, whether it's UTCP or UDD. So those are some of the data that's from various deployments. You may not see them visibly, but basically it shows the 16 megabits and 12 megabits capacity that we'll be able to, that we're able to get live from the network. So how is the data deployment in Kenya as regards TVWS space? Once we finished the pilot, the question CAK went back, visited several countries, did their own study, and then they decided that for you to deploy TVWS space, you must use a broadcast signal distributor. So no other telecom company can do that unless you partner with a BSD. And that's how they decided. So a BSD will have to either look for a national facilities provider or a national facilities provider look for a BSD. And then the two will work together to deploy it in US space. In fact, when I was here in the morning, just saw an email that we and Signet have been allowed to do it statewide. So I think we're going to make a very big announcement as Mawingu in the next few weeks.